Times a week, right?
Arrivo.
So we're going to have Krishna evening today.
Arrivo.
More and more remembrance of Krishna. We heard some singing. Now we're going to hear some qualities, pastimes, features, and many glories of the person who's going to appear soon, around 12 o'clock. So in that sequence, I'm going to ask some devotees to speak on Krishna, whatever they feel like. So first of all, request Rasik Mohan Prabhu to speak something of Krishna, and then later we're going to hear from some other devotees also, and in between some speaking, more Maha Mantra and more singing, right? In this way we are going to celebrate Krishna evening, Krishna Janmashtami. Hare Krishna.
हरे कृष्ण ओम ज्ञानतिमिरंगस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. वंदेहं श्रीगुरुवरं श्रीरूपारूढप्रवरं व्रजदासरसिकं च नारायणं तं प्रणमामि. श्रीगुरुचरणं वंदे रामनपृष्ठाय भूतले रूपानुगभक्तिरं च कृपामूर्ते नारायणं. गुरुं नारायणत्यन्तं वंदे विनोदपुस्तकं यत्पारस्मृतिमात्रेण धामो भवति. नमो महावृन्दाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णा कृष्ण चैतन्यनामे. हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते. तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिय. जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासवी गौर भक्त वृंद एवरीबॉडी बोलो हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे. वन मोर टाइम. हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे. बोलो प्रेमानंद श्याम सुंदर जी की जय. बोलो वृंदावन बिहार की जय. बोलो जय जय श्री राधे श्याम. हरी बोल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय कोटि दंडवत प्रणाम टू माय परम आराध्य गुरुपाद पद्म विष्णुपाद स्तोत्र तथा श्री श्रीमद् भक्ति वेदांत नारायण स्वामी महाराज श्री गुरुदेव अंजलि तायुपानु के गौरी गुरु बाड़गा अंदर पूज्यपाद महाराज जी एंड अंटू ऑल यू वैष्णवस वैष्णवीस डिसिपल्स हियर टुडे म्यूजिक सब माय दंडवत प्रणाम. आई एम वेरी ऑनर्ड टू बी प्रेजेंट अमंग यू ऑल हियर. जस्ट द अदर डे आई हैड अ फोन कॉल विद पूज्यपाद प्रेमानंद प्रभु जी एंड ही सेड एक्चुअली डोंट थिंक यू आर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम वृंदावन. व्हेरेवर द वैष्णवस आर प्रेजेंट Krishna is present, Vrindavan is present. That Govinda Vishram, where does Govinda stay? Now Govinda Dev is about to appear externally, but we hear even for the Sringadev, Antaran Sringa, Bahir Sringa, he's everywhere. He's in the heart of the Vaishnava. Lord Bhagavan in Bhagavatam says that I am always in the heart of the Vaishnava. गोविंद विश्राम साधवो हृदयम मायाम साधवो हृदयतयम वरण्यतेन जानन्ति नहं तेजो मनसति. Vishnu is always in the heart of the sadhu. He says, the sadhu's heart is my resting place. Therefore, I'm very honored to be here with Maharaji, with all assembled devotees. Wherever there is some Krishna Bhakti present, that Krishna Bhakti beach, there Krishna is also present. And actually, we were hearing that. So we are in the Association of Vaishnavas observing this festival. Now I will speak a few minutes, about some basic idea of what is Janmashtami. One thing to understand is that Krishna is Param Satya. He is the eternal absolute truth. So how can we say he is appearing? He is eternal. Just like the Jiva is eternal, how is he appearing? And if we look at the very first verse of the Srimad Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam is giving us an indication about the nature and the glories of the absolute truth. So what is the Bhagavatam saying? We know, okay, Bhagavan is Satya, he's eternal. Just like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, O Arjuna, I am eternal, you are eternal, we are all eternal. So what does it mean that Krishna is appearing today? Very interesting thing. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada writes in his Bhagavad purport that actually we should understand that Krishna is appearing at every instant. There's one very interesting purport Prabhupada gives where he says that if you take the smallest part of time, this is called like nimesha, it is the time that it takes a ray of light traveling at the speed of light to cross over one atom. At every moment of those, Krishna is appearing in another Brahmanda. So for example, within a minute, Krishna has appeared in millions and millions of Brahmandas. So Swami Maharaj Prabhupada said that actually, at every moment Krishna is appearing. The problem is that now we are Jivas, we are Krishna Bahirmukh. We are turned away from Krishna, we do not see Krishna, therefore we do not feel His presence. Even though He is always with us. Because we are covered by anartha, covered by maya, we don't see Krishna. But He is here. He is here now. He is in every atom as Paramatma, Shiva Dakshaya Vishnu. And yet there is some speciality of Shri Krishna Janmashtami. Because He is appearing now. Here. But also we should not think, oh, Krishna is only appearing in Vrindavan. He's not appearing in New York. When Swami Maharaj Prabhupada went to London, he made Sri Radha Londonishwar. People were saying, what is this Londonishwar? Arey, Bhagavan is Jagannath. Jagannath means whole world, not only this earth, but whole universe Nath. He is the Lord of the whole universe. Why not also the Nath of London and New York? That's why our acharyas very boldly proclaim the glories of Sri Krishna. That we should not be timid and afraid, oh, we are some like minority group here in America, Krishna is over there. No, we are just, what are we? What is our identity? Gopi, Bhartu, Parakamalayo, Dasa, Dasa, Nudasa. That's Sri Krishna. We are servants of that Krishna, who is the master of the universe, all the universes.
GPD, triple D.
Yes. We are Gopi, Bhartu, Parakamalayo, Dasa, Dasa, Nudasa. Therefore, we should not be like mice, Gurudev would say. You should not be like mice. You should be bold like lions to preach. So Janmashtami means, today Krishna is appearing at this time. Because these holy days are a very great opportunity for us to completely concentrate our mind and heart in Sri Krishna. Therefore, He very mercifully appears again and again. Vaishnava is the same way. Again, they're giving us these teachings. They appear, they disappear. Sri Krishna is giving us these teachings. And He's showing, no, I am appearing now. Even though I am present always. In the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, it's a very beautiful verse. It goes, Janmadhyasya yatonvayadi taratas charteshva vigyasvarat tene brahma hridaya adi kavaye muyanti atsuraya तेजो वारी मृदम यतावि निमयो यत्रात्रि सर्गो मृधा धम्नस्य न सदा निरस्त गुहकम् सत्यं परम धीमहि. This is the very first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. So actually, now we are saying Krishna, when did he appear? Historians say, we don't know. But the Shastra says, scientists, they argue this and that. But Shastra says, okay, 5,247 years now. 5,200 years, 47 like that. But actually, this is Krishna's appearance on this Bhumandala. But he is in Paradham, Golokam, eternally. And yet he has appeared this time. But the Shastra is saying, Satyam Param Dimahi. We meditate on that absolute truth. On this day of Janmasthami, we try to absorb our mind as much as possible to Krishna. This is the process that is given by our acharyas. Srila Rupa Goswami described, Krishna Bhavanamrita. How can we become fully absorbed in Sri Krishna? Krishna Bhakti Rasa Bhavitamati Kriyatam Jadi Kutopi Labhyate Tatra Lohem Api Mulyam Ekalam Janma Koti Sukriterna Labhyate. That if you want to be absorbed in Sri Krishna, in Krishna consciousness, you must absorb your mind and heart in Sri Krishna. This is Krishna Bhakti Ras, and this cannot be gained through millions of lifetimes of pious activities. This is a transcendental thing. Actually, this is Namaparaja thing, or ordinary pious activities or something like that is equal to Krishna Bhakti. So by absorbing our mind completely in Krishna, on these days we are fasting and we are trying to do nothing else but absorb our mind and heart in Sri Krishna. Then we pray, Janmadasyata. Oh Krishna, may you appear in my heart as well. May you appear in my heart. Because you are everywhere, but I am not with you. Krishna is everywhere. He is here. In London, New York, everywhere, every country, every place, the whole universe. But why am I not with him? Meaning, why is my consciousness not absorbed in him? We have gone distance. So we are praying that how can we come close to you? How can you appear in my heart? Janma, Rasita, O Krishna, Janma. How can your appearance come in my heart? Jayati Janani Vasa Devaki Janma Vado. O Krishna, how will you appear? Jayati, in my heart. That is our prayer. We pray like this too also to Guru Pada Padma. Guru Pada Padma is also eternal. But we are praying, O Gurudev, please appear in my heart. And this is proper understanding of a disciple. That disciple knows to honor all Vaishnavas and all living entities because they know that Krishna is in their hearts. Mahaprabhu said, Jive Saman Jive Jani Krishna Adhisthan. Honor all living entities knowing Krishna is in their heart. And yet even though Krishna is in our heart, we are performing so many strange activities in Maya. So therefore we pray, O Krishna Buli Seji Manadi Pahimu. We've become turned away from Krishna since such a long time. So now, Anjanmasthami, let us make the prayer. Oh Krishna, please, show yourself to me. In Vedanta Sutra commentaries of Jiva Goswami, he says, actually, even for Gayatri Mantra is eternal. And yet the sages are manifesting the Gayatri Mantras, the Veda Mantras. So are the sages the parents of the mantras? But the Gayatri Mantra is eternal. And Jiva Goswami says, just like Krishna is eternal. And yet, Devaki Vasudev, Nanda Jashoda are like his parents. Why? Because of their love for Krishna. They have so much love for Krishna. We see Devaki Vasudev, Nanda Jashoda, for many lifetimes they were meditating on Krishna. Their whole life only meditating on Krishna. You look at Dhruva Maharaj, you look at Narad Rishi, you look at Prahlad Maharaj, how much sadhana bhajan they did. Then Krishna appears in their heart. Dhruva Maharaj, Krishna appeared in his heart. He said, why don't you come out? Then Lord Narayan appeared before him. Even though his bhakti was not one-pointed, Ananya Bhakti, Dhruva Maharaj was not one-pointed in his devotion to Krishna. He wanted material desires. Let me be greater than my father, my grandfather. And yet, because of his absorption, his Krishna consciousness, Krishna appeared. Lord Narayan appeared. So if we see Nanda Yashoda, how much love, they are eternal associates. But also, they are showing us by example how much absorption, how much one-pointedness they had. And therefore Krishna appeared to them. So we pray that, oh Krishna, please, may I develop this one-pointed devotion to you. That now we see it's very easy to have Krishna in an altar and spend some time for him. Give him some diyabati, some lamp, offering something once a day. But most of the time is our consciousness absorbed in my Lala. Like Jashoda, whenever her distraction, whenever there was a little distraction, Krishna made some problem. Sakha Jasura came, Samayata problem came, Trinavarta came, So our absorption, our consciousness will be always in that Krishna Chinta. Always absorbed in Sri Krishna. Then certainly Krishna will appear. Otherwise, one Janmashtami will go, another Janmashtami will go. Every moment is Janmashtami. But is it Janmashtami now for me in my heart? Krishna is in everyone's heart as Paramatma. And yet, I have no love for him. And therefore, Bhaktivinoda Thakur sings, Saranga Sharanagati Hoibe Jahar Tahara Prarthana Suni Sri Nanda Kumar. Krishna will hear our prayers when we are surrendered completely. Then he will appear before us. Then he can appear everywhere in front of us. Like the gopis. The gopis showed how you can make Krishna appear. When Krishna disappeared, it's not that he's gone. Krishna was hiding, looking. How much love and devotion they had. When Krishna disappeared from other places, people weren't so attached. We don't hear that the Dwarka Queens were crying in separation when Krishna would go here and there. But he disappeared for a moment, all the gopis felt like they could not live without him. They became so absorbed in Krishna, they began to feel like, imitate Krishna's pastimes, like I'm Krishna. They were so absorbed. And then they took shelter of Srimati Radhika, sat together, and they began to do kirtan. That's why on Janmashtami, every day actually, we should do kirtan. But especially on days like this, we come together and we do sankirtan. Following the gopis. Gopi Bhartu Parakamaliya, what did the gopis do? Radhika said, no need to run around trying to find Krishna. Sit down. Do kirtan, Krishna will come. If you have bhakti, one of the qualities of bhakti is that it attracts Krishna. Krishna Karshani. So if we call out to Krishna with devotion, Krishna is attracted. Like the gopis, they sat down and what did they do?
Jayati te dikam janmana braja shrayata indira sasvaratra hi.
The gopis saying, Jayati te dikam janmana braja. O Krishna, you appear in Braj. Jayati Devika, O Krishna, how glorious you are. You appear in Braj, and yet you have gone away. Why don't you come before us? So we pray to Krishna today, oh please Krishna, please appear before us. Let us see you. Let us have that vision that we can see, oh Guru Pad Padma is before me. Let us have that devotion. We know He is in our heart, but let us also see you before me. Reveal your sweet smiling face to me. Krishna is very beautiful and very sweet. So we should try to develop love for Him, because He is our true beloved. For all living entities, He is the one and only beloved. That's why Srila Rupa Goswami prays in the first verse of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Rupa Goswami says, Akila Rasamrita Murti Prashrimala Ruchiruda Taraka Vali Kalita Shama Dalito Radha Preyam Vidur Jayati. O Krishna, all glories to you, you attract everyone. All the gopis, all the living entities are attracted to you. Bhardayan Kamadevan, you are Kamadev. Everyone is attracted to you. So please, Krishna, appear before us. So Krishna appears today in Sri Brajadam. So many wonderful pastimes are there. You'll hear from other Vaishnavas, you'll hear from Maharaj. So many sweet pastimes which attract the hearts of the devotees. Krishna is so merciful that He manifests His very attractive pastimes. We see the Lord appears in many incarnations, and yet we are not so attracted. The Sringadev, very beautiful, very attractive. But He is not stealing the hearts of the devotees. He is not Makan Shor. We don't hear the Sringadev is Makan Shor. He is not Chir Adan Chor. He is Anartha Chor. He is Ugramurti. Parshuram. Some nice pastimes. So many nice pastimes, but Krishna in the Bhagavatam says, Anugrahaya Bhaktanam Manushyam Nehmashritam. He appears, Yadrishim Tadrisha Krida. He performs such wonderful pastimes that everyone is attracted to Him. Therefore, we will hear these pastimes of Krishna and try to give our hearts to Him. And understand, Maharaj will speak, I'm sure, more. We'll hear from other Vaishnavas more. But Krishna is Brajendra Nandan Shama Sundar. Our Guru Pada Padma, every year on Janmashtami, he would have a this debate, not a debate, but like a conference in Madhura Dham, Keshati Gaudiya Math, that who is Krishna? Vasudeva Nandan, Yashoda Nandan. And in Madhura Dham, in the place where everyone is, Dwarkadish Paksha, Madhura Paksha. Everyone takes the side there of Dwarkadish Krishna. He is Vasudeva Nandan, he is foster son of Yashoda Nandan. They are Gwala, cowherd boys, cowherd people. They are not aristocratic people like us.
there is this kind of competition, spiritual competition. And Gurudev would hold discussion on this and invite all the different pundits. But Gurudev always would hear everyone's point, but then he would establish with all his devotees, with all his pundits, all his scholarly disciples, he would establish Krishna is Brajendra Nandan Shyama Sundar. Once in Nubraj, in our Gurukul, Gurudev asked this question, who is Krishna? Is he Nandanandan, Brajendra Nandan? Who is he? He is, what does it say? Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachinananda Vigraha Anadi Adi Govinda Sarva Karana Karana. He is Anadi Adi. He is beginning without beginning, cause of cause. How is he Nandanandan, son of Nanda? And they said, no, he is Nandanandan. He is Yashoda Nandan. This is the eternal truth. This is the eternal rasa, is higher than this mundane, not spiritual also. Gurudev said, ultimately this rasa tattva is higher than even jnana or bhakti like tattva. Gurudev said, this is the topmost thing. Ultimately Gurudev said, you want loving relation with Krishna? Give up this mentality, oh he is the personality of God, he is Adi Adi Govinda, he is Sarva Karana Karana. Think of him as Gopi Pranadam, Gopi Jana Balava. He is Nanda Nanda, he is Yashoda Nanda. Then you can develop love and relation with him. Gurudev would establish, what is the proof? The gopis, what do they say? Jayati Devikam Janmana Braja. They don't say Janmana Mathura. They say Janmana Braja. When Yogamaya appeared in the jailhouse of Kamsa and she rose up and kicked Kamsa in the face and said, fool, you are trying to kill me? Your killer has appeared elsewhere. Yogamaya is not a liar. She did not say he was born here and then left. She said, oh, your killer is born in another place. Meaning, he is there. And also in Bhagavatam, there's a slogan which says that Jata Karma, the umbilical cord cutting ceremony, was performed in Braj. When Uddhava and others were saying, oh Krishna, he is Devaki Nandan, they said, what do you think? We're fools. You weren't here. All of us were here in Braj. When Krishna was born, we had a great ceremony and the different ceremonies, samskars, like cutting the umbilical cord was performed, Gurudev would say. So he is Pranada Nandan Shyam Sundar. And in Mathura Dham, the same time he appeared in his Vasudev Murti, four-armed form, as Narayan. And then by the request of Devaki Vasudev, they said, oh please appear in a form like a bala, like a boy. So then he appeared. But really he is Nanda Nanda and Yashoda Nanda. So there's so many things we hear. I pray to everyone. I pray to Maharaji. If I have said anything incorrectly, please verify. So many wonderful pastimes of Sri Krishna. This is a very joyous occasion for all of us. This time of Chaturmasya is a very joyous occasion. Guru Purnima, Baladev Purnima, Jula Nyatra, Shri Rupa Swami, Sthiti. Now, Shri Krishna Janmashtami, Shri Radhastami, soon coming Deepavali, Anukut, Sarat Purnima, all these Giraj Anukut, so many wonderful festivals. So this is like, again, we're so lucky to be in this line, Gaudiya Vaishnava line. Every day is like a festival. And every moment is said in the Brahma Sangeeta. And every step is like a dance, every word is like a song. This is the process we're in. So I pray to everyone.
Spoke so well regarding Krishna Tattva, explaining the details of Varshala Gurudeva, Gurupad Padma. He used to establish in that conference every year. Gurudeva used to hold that conference in Mathura, inviting so many scholars from around the world. From Braj Mandal, and everyone, it goes for 5-6 days, not only one day. All scholars are very learned and they used to speak so much details of Krishna Tattva. But there is one point which did not impress Srila Gurudev, and that is that they established that Krishna took birth in Mathura. and his Devki Nandan, his Vasudev Nandan. But Gaudiya Vaishnavas, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the associates of Mahaprabhu, with evidence they establish that Krishna never leaves Braj and that there is two Krishna, there is not one Krishna. There is Yashoda Nandan Krishna and there is Devki Nandan Krishna. In the last, when everyone spoke up, in the last Gurudev, he used to conclude his words, giving all these evidences, which he said few of them. Gurudev used to give examples, now evidences from Bhagavatam. Nandastu Atman Utpanne Jat Halad Mahamana Ayu Vipra Vedya Sanat Suchit Arankrita. At the beginning of Nand Mahotsav, the chapter, Shri Shukadev Goswami, he started the second chapter with this verse. Nandastu Atmaj Utpanne Jat Halat Mahamana Atmat Jayat Putraha. Scripture says, the very soul of father take birth as son. The soul of father take birth as son. So Nandastu Atmaj Utpanne, Shukadev Goswami is saying, it's not that Krishna is brought from somewhere else or being brought from Mathura and kept in Braj, in Gokul. But actually Krishna took birth in Gokul. And that Krishna is the son of Devaki is just vivad, is just controversy. Jayati janivaso, Devaki janavado. There's only vivad is a controversy. And that controversy became backed by many Hindi movies in India, in which they directed and the producer, the director showing that Krishna took birth in the jail, in the prison house of Kamsa, and Vasudev Maharaj kept Krishna in Gokul and brought that young girl, which Yashoda Maiya gave birth to, back to Mathura. So, कन्हैया किसको कहेगा तू मैया एक ने तुझको जन्म दिया और एक ने तुझको पाला वो भजन सुनते आ रहे सत्युग से
अरे वाह
हाँ इन इंडिया एवरीवन बिलीव दिस बिकॉज़ दे बिलीव मोर इन द मूवीज रादर देन बिलीविंग इन भागवतम दे बिलीव मोर इन मूवीज बट दे डोंट बिलीव भागवतम एंड दे डोंट वांट टू हियर फ्रॉम अथॉरिटेटिव सोर्स. So, Nandastu Atmaj Utpanne, O Nand Maharaj, your own soul, means your Krishna, has taken birth in Gokul. It's not Krishna which is brought from somewhere else. That's one evidence. I'm just giving one hint, but there is many details of this. Then, Shri Gargacharyaji came from Mathura to give name ceremony up to voice. On the lap of Mother Yashoda and on the lap of Mother Rohini. And just by seeing the boy on the lap of Mother Rohini, Shri Gargacharya said, I am the Rohini Putra Ramyam Suridgane. And when he saw Krishna, he was about to faint. Why he fainted? Nanda Maharaj woke him up, brought him back to consciousness. Oh Gargacharya, what happened? He said, who am I? What is my name? He said, you are Gargacharya. And who are you? He said, I am Nanda Maharaj. You came from Mathura to give to name ceremony of my voice and you forgot your name. And Gargacharya said, yes, because this boy is not ordinary. Tasman Nanda Atmajamte Narayana Samaguna. O Nanda Maharaj, he is your Atmaj, he is your son. Tasman Nanda Atmajamte Narayan Samaguna. And now this is something very funny going on here. Shri Gargacharyaji explaining, according to opponent's perspective of Krishna, that means his qualities surpass the quality of Lord Narayan. But Nanda Maharaj taking the words of Gargacharyaji according to what his understanding is that then don't get worried. Sometimes the qualities of Narayana will reflect on your son Krishna and he will do so much miracles. So don't get worried when you do such things. So they both, he's taking something else and he's understanding something else. It's all the point of Madhurya, the sweetness and the opulence perspective of Sri Gargacharya. So Nandastu Tasma Nand Atmajante Narayana Sumudra. This is another evidence which proves that Gargacharya can never tell lie. He's sadhu. He's the same person. The third evidence. Brahma, the creator, cannot tell lie. In the Brahma Stuti, the very first verse Brahmaji spoke, when he felt that I offended Krishna by taking away his calves and cowherd boys, so Brahmaji came with repentance mood, fell at the feet of Krishna and asked forgiveness, uttering this verse, praising Krishna and giving the identity of Krishna. Nobetyate avrapushu tadidambaraya gunja vata parepikshal sanmukhaya pade sajjar kaunar vetra shan vetra lakshmashya midupade kashupankajaya. Oh my worshipful Krishna, I pay my obeisance to you. And he described the beauty of Krishna. The beauty of Krishna is dark complexion, just like dark rain clouds. He is wearing yellow garment, pitambar, just like there's lighting in the clouds. Then, in the last, Pashupanka Jaya. You are the son of Jaya, means the sun. You are the Jaya of, son of, maintainer of animal, maintainer of cows. So, who's maintaining cows? Is Vasudev Maharaj ever maintaining cows? Or is Shridhan Maharaj maintaining cows? How many cows does Maharaj have?
900,000 cows.
He is maintaining cows. He is Braj Raj. He is the king of Braj. So Pashu Panka Jaya. Here comes the point. Brahmaji, he proves Krishna is the son of Nanda Maharaj. And whatever you hear, other than that, is Jayati Janivaso Deti Janivati. Krishna took birth in Braj and everything else is controversy. Just give up controversy. Throw away this and believe in this words of the Shastras. Gopis cannot tell lie, as he just said. The very first stroke of Gopi Gita. Jayati te dika janmana raja shayatai. Daita Dikshuta, Dikshuta Vaka, Tais
Viva, Tam Vishikshate,
Tvai Dita Sava, Tam Vichinvate, Jayati Te Dikam Janna Vrasa. O Krishna, O Shyam Sundar, the moment you have taken birth in Braj, this Braj has become the sportive place of Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune. Lakshmi here means Sar Lakshmi Mai, means Radha Rani, the sportive, playful place of Shri Radha Rani. So Jayati Tadikam Janmana Braja. All this evidences from Bhagavatam, Vedas, Puranas proves Krishna is Yashodananda. And how he is Yashodananda? I will tell this later, very nearly to the time 11:30 to 12.
Birth
of Krishna. Bolo Vrindavan Bihari Lal
Ki Jai.
So very well he spoke about Krishna in very short time. I will request now for very sweet Prem Pradeep Prabhu to speak some of the glories of Krishna.
That's my day.
I want to.
That's my day. question maybe. One question.
Later, question later. Nandu stuff tomorrow. Question.
Balade, he always comes first. He is making the
platform, the place, giving the potency, strength, he is always coming first. Then we know that Subhadra Devi comes first, then finally Krishna. So, Baladev Prabhu, what is the meaning of this sat? Gurudev said, very simple explanation is, we can see by the reflection in the hearts of all jivas. Because Krishna is also simultaneously not different and different from his Shakti, that means we can say the jiva is somehow inconceivably one and different with Bhagavan. So his jiva has the difference of quantity, but some of the same quality. So we can see reflecting in everyone, nobody wants to die naturally. At least we can say everyone is interested in living. Okay, maybe so much conditioning, so much karma, so many problems. A jiva can say, oh, I want to die, I want to die. But really, in the essence, the whole world is moving because people want to live. So, Buddha said this is the reflection of Sat. Sat is existence potency and the facility, the space for everything else to build on that. What is next? Sat Chit. What is Chit? Many times it's translated as knowledge. And just saying the word knowledge, I personally don't really understand what that means. But Gurudev said very simply, one time Krishna was traveling from Gokul to Vrindavan when they were moving all the Vrajvasis under Nanda Baba. And he was sitting with his mother and saying, looking out of the cart and saying, oh, mother, what is this? What is this? Why is this tree? He said, why is this big Rishi sitting there? And his mother said, no, that is not Rishi, that is Bhamsi Bhakti. No, that is Banyu tree. That is Banyu tree. No, he has dreadlocks. Why does he have dreadlocks? Why is he sitting there? What's he doing? And he said, Gurudev explained very sweetly how Krishna is just an innocent little boy saying, oh, what is this? What is this? And he says, all jivas, especially when they're young, they're like this. What is this? What is this? Why is this? Who is this? Everyone asks questions. This is a natural thing in the jivas. So this is a reflection of the potency of chit. Everyone wants knowledge. Everyone wants to understand. So when there is the platform and the space and then there is the knowledge, then what? All jivas want to be happy. Of course, we already explained. Some can say, no, I don't like happiness, but that's just conditioning and strange things in their mind. Everyone wants to be happy. No one wants to be uncomfortable. No one likes discomfort. Everyone wants to be happy. This is ananda. Sat, chit, ananda. So, I forgot to mention, like the predominant deity of Sandini Shakti or Sat as Baladev Prabhu, the predominating deity of Chit is Krishna himself, and the predominating deity of Ananda is Srimati Radharani. And all of this together is that Sri Krishna that our Guru Parampara is saying is the complete Bhagavan who we worship. They say, Radha Krishna Pranaya Mahima. Radha Krishna, Pranaya Mahima, Kadini Shakti Rasman, Ekat Manavati, Bhuvi, Vedam Gatoto, Chaitanyakam, Prakita Madanat, Tatlam, Chaitanyakam, Radha Bhagavad Gita, Suvalitam Nomi Krishna Swarupam. So, Krishna and his Shakti together, that is the absolute truth. That is Bhagavan as we know, as we are learning from Arshad Gurudev and Guru Parampara. So, they are only separated, that absolute truth only appears separate for their love to be expressed and the pastimes to happen. And those pastimes
we understand janma karma samayajyam evam yogiti tatvata tyaktva deham punarjanma naiti mameti swarjanam. Those pastimes are what our Srila Gurudev is so, was 24 hours speaking. And that's what he wanted to share with us, because he knows that if we hear those pastimes from him and try somehow to learn them and also do kirtan, repeating them, then that is the best perfection, that is the quickest way for perfection. Srila Gurudev used to say to the devotees in the temple, I don't want anything from you. You don't need to do anything. As long as you come to my Harikatha and sit here, just hear from me, I don't want anything more. Other people will say there's so many rules, do this, do this, do this, but really I just want this from you, and your life will be completely successful. You will be transformed and you will be fixed up servant of Sri Adam Krishna. So, we are very lucky to have so many messengers of the message of Srila Gurudev, and I will not take any more of your time because we want to hear from them. Gurudev Gaurachandra Radhikaya Tadali Krishna Krishna Bhakta Tagbhakta Namoham Om Agyana Timurandasya Gyana Gyana Shalakaya Chakshur Undiyatamyena Tasmai Shri Gurudev Pancha Kalpatur Vascha Kripa Sindhu Vyadacha Patita Nam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namoham. So I offer my obeisances to the lotus feet of Srila Gurudev, Shiksha Gurudev, or Guru Parampara, the Supreme Lord, all Vaishnavas, Vaishnavas, the Siddhi. So, I know Maharaj has always put me to this. And really and truly, we all want to hear from Maharaj. But just to obey his instruction, and I just speak a little thing. Just by a show of hands, all who say Krishna is the son of Vasudeva Devaki. Nobody? Krishna is the son of Vasudeva Devaki. Anybody? Yes? Who say yes? All who believe that. And all who say that Krishna is the son of Yashoda and Nanda Baba. Raise your hands. These are all scholars. Two hands now. You have two more?
Chaturbhuj hiding.
So, general people, common people, they say that Krishna is the son of Vasudeva Devaki. This is ordinary people say this. As Maharaj was saying, because, you know, many people, they have so much of faith in movies. They see the Indian movies and these things and so on, and they have the faith in there. And ordinary people say that Krishna is the son of Vasudeva and Devaki.
Vasudeva
and Devaki. But if you look, according to Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna did not take birth from the womb of Devaki. How Krishna come? He appeared. How he appeared? As huge Chaturbhuj form, four-handed form. Then Devaki and Vasudev, they pray. Oh, they recognize, oh, you are no other than Parabrahma. You are no other than Narayan himself. You are no other than Vishnu himself. Your Supreme Lord. And then they pray, oh Lord, please come as baby form. Then Vishnu, he come as a little baby. So he did not take birth from the womb of baby. Y'all know this from the movies, right? Then long story short, Vasudev picked up a little baby and went across the Yamuna. And there he went to Yashoda Maya, and then they said he picked up the daughter of Yashoda Maya and Nanda Baba and brought her back. Right? This is what you know in the movies. Partially correct. So what happened? Yes, little baby from the cell. Vasudev took him to Gokul.
Vasudev.
Vasudev. Okay. So he took him there. But what happened? What is the secret? Sastras explain there are two Bhagavats. Granta Bhagavat and Bhakta Bhagavat. Granta Bhagavat is a book Bhagavat. And Bhakta Bhagavat is the devotee Bhagavat. The two are not different. The devotee Bhagavat have fully realized Granta Bhagavat. If ordinary person read Granta Bhagavat means the book Bhagavat, they cannot understand it. But if Bhakta Bhagavat explain Granta Bhagavat, then we can have real understanding. So ordinary people just read certain things and say, ha ha ha, this is it. And everybody believe that, general people, ordinary people believe that Krishna is the son of Vasudev and Devaki. But the self-realized devotees, those self-realized souls, those pure souls, they back to Bhagavan. Those persons who have realized the true purports of the Granta, of the scriptures, they say that Krishna is the son of Yashoda and Nanda Baba. Yashoda, Maya, gave birth to twins. General people do not know this. It was all a secret. Because everybody knows that Kamsa wanted to kill Krishna. So everything was a secret. So that is why the general people do not know this. This is top secret. Only the Brajabasis, only the residents of Vrindavan, only the residents of Gokul knew this. No one else. So much so, even the Devatas cannot understand who is Krishna. As we know with Lord Indra, when he was showering on the thunderbolt, he couldn't understand Krishna. Even the creator of this material universe could not understand who is this Krishna, Lord Brahma. What to speak of ordinary persons? So this was secret. The Brajabasis, forget about what other people will write and say. The Brajabasis, they witnessed this. They witnessed that Yashoda Maya gave birth to twins. So how can you tell them that no, this wasn't true? They saw the umbilical cord. They saw Krishna take birth from the womb of Yashoda Maya. Understand this? So those self-realized souls, all our acharyas, this is their conclusion. So who do we follow? Should we follow the movies or should we follow the pure devotees of the Lord? Understand? So don't be cheated. So this is one great mystery as Maharaj and the devotees then were speaking about. We should also understand Krishna. A little bit of Krishna. Krishna Tattva. Who is Krishna? Srimad Bhagavatam said, Ite Kamsa Kalapum Saha Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. All incarnations, he said Vishnu incarnation, Vamana avatar, Narsingha avatar, Matsya avatar, Koma avatar, Ram, all these are incarnations. But who is Krishna? Srimad Bhagavatam said Krishna is known as Swayam Bhagavan. Everybody else is known as Bhagavan. But Krishna is known as Swayam Bhagavan. Why is Krishna known as Swayam Bhagavan? Because Krishna, he is the sum total of all the Bhagavans. Hence he is known as Avatari. Everyone else is Avatar, but Krishna is Avatari. When you can put all the, you know, our charges said, it might be possible to count the hair on the cow. Might be possible. It might be possible to count the sun on the beach. But it's impossible to count the different forms of Krishna. Impossible. So many unlimited forms Krishna have. Our material mind cannot conceive this. But when you gather all those forms of Krishna and you put them together, he is known as Swayam Bhagavan, Vajrajanandana Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam is the evidence of this. Lord Brahma also said in Brahma Samhita, Prabhuji quote the verse, Ishwara Parama Krishna. Ishwara Parama. There are many Ishwaras, there are many controllers. One controlling the moon, one controlling the sun, this one controlling the rain, this one controlling that. Everyone is so many persons, so many Ishwaras. But Krishna, he is Parama Ishwara. Ishwara Parama. Who is saying this? Lord Brahma, the creator of this material universe, he's making this statement. Not an ordinary man. Not no movie director is making this statement. Lord Brahma himself is making this statement. Ishwara Parama Krishna, that Krishna, he is the supreme. Sachit Ananda Vigraha. His form is made of eternality, knowledge, and bliss. So Prabhuji was given hint. Ishwara Parama Krishna, Sachit Ananda Vigraha, Anadir Adir Govinda. That this Krishna, there's no beginning, there's no ending. Krishna taking birth, appearing in this material world, this is just a Naravat pastime. This is just human-like pastimes. In order to please his devotees, Krishna appeared mercifully. But Krishna is not an ordinary man or woman who take birth. And Adir, he has no beginning. So if someone has no beginning, how can you say you take birth? So Krishna appeared, mercifully appeared. Also, there's no ending to Krishna. So, Krishna also leave. Sarva Karana Karanam. And he is the cause of all causes. Lastly, I remember this beautiful verse by Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, which sums our whole Gaudiya Vedanta philosophy. If we can understand this one verse, we can understand everything. Arada Bhagavan Rajesha Tanayas Tadam Vrindavanam Ramya Kachit Upasana Vraja Vadu Vargena Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Premapum Arto Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matam Idam Tatudara Na Paraha. What are our charges saying? Arada Bhagavan Rajesha Tanayas. We should worship that Krishna. We should have one-pointed bhakti for that Krishna. Which Krishna? That Krishna in Vrindavan. Not Krishna in Mathura and Dwarka. These are Krishna's expansion. They are known as Mathuradesh, Dwarkadesh Krishna. There are expansions of Krishna. Partial. But full Krishna resides where? In Vrindavan. Maharaj will explain more how that partial Krishna in Mathura, how went and merged into the full Krishna that was in Gokul. This ordinary people cannot understand this. That's why Krishna is God. He's inconceivable. Cannot understand. Can only be understood by bhakti. Vrajesha Tanayas, Tadam Vrindavanam. Just as Krishna is worshipped, so is his dham. Raja Vadu Vargino. We should follow in the footsteps of who? Which devotees? Those, that group, Raja Bhadu, that group headed by Srimati Radharani. Our Srila Gurudeva said that Sri Janamashtami is no other than a glorification of Srimati Radharani. If one wants to please Krishna, then we should glorify Srimati Radharani. Then Krishna becomes happy. And if one wants to please Srimati Radharani, then we should glorify who?
Krishna.
So that's why Acharya say we worship Yogala Kishore, both Radha and Krishna. Some persons only want to worship Krishna and don't want to worship Srimati Radharani. But this way we can never get pure bhakti. So that is why Mahaprabhu said, Raja Bhadu Margina. We follow the mood and worship of the gopis headed by Srimati Radharani. What is the evidence of this? Srimad Bhagavatam, Pramanam, the spotless Pramanam. The Srimad Bhagavatam. Earlier, well, sometimes ago we was reading, Sri Vyasadev compiled so many different scriptures, but yet he wasn't happy. Then, in his ripe, maturity, he composed the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is the essence of all scriptures. This is the evidence. So no one need to have any doubts about this. Simply read Srimad Bhagavatam. This is the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This line that we're so fortunate to be in, this Gaudiya Vaishnava line, we're so fortunate, this is the teaching. Anything other than this, we have no regards or respect or inclination for. Hari Bol. Pancha Kalpa Turvasya Kripa Sindhu Devacha Pantana Pavadevyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namah.
Hare Krishna. We are very close to 12 o'clock. Huh? Thank you. Just 10 minutes, Ma Mantra, then I'll speak. You want to speak?
Yeah,
I'll give you golden time, very near to 12 o'clock.
Golden time.
Golden time, very near to the birth of Krishna.
Shari.
Hare Krishna.